Carl the Caveman. Here we go, gentlemen. One day, Carl the Caveman was riding a really big veggie-eating dinosaur. Carl was kind of a crazy caveman. He was chunky, hairy, and bald. Carl comes from a big family of chunky, hairy, bald cavemen and women. Yes, the cave women were bald too. The big veggie-eating dinosaur's name was Bob. Carl loved his dinosaur and was often laughed at because he taught Bob to do a very fun trick with one command, ooga. Bob the dinosaur would lift a big heavy rock into the air and drop it from on high, breaking the rock into little pieces. This came in very handy when big rocks needed to be turned into little rocks. Carl was riding the big veggie-eating dinosaur because he was headed to the big rock ball game. It was the championship rock ball game and Carl's favorite sport. In fact, it was the only sport ever invented because this happened a long, long time ago. In rock ball, a caveman must push a really heavy rock across a field full of snakes before a big old T-Rex eats him. It was great fun to watch. Today, as Carl parked the big veggie-eating dinosaur, he heard screaming from the crowd and the screaming of another poor caveman who didn't push his rock fast enough. Carl couldn't wait to get into the stadium to watch the festivities. He hurried toward the entrance, pushing other cavemen that weren't bald out of his way. And then, he wasn't watching where he was going, and he wanted the best seat possible when he burst through a door and he realized, yes, he had the best seat in the house. In fact, he was inside the arena. Boom, the door slammed behind him and then he heard the cheers from the crowd. They were cheering for him, even though he was in mortal danger of being eaten alive. For the first time in his life, the fat, bald, hairy caveman was very popular and he liked that. But reality set in when he heard a blood-curdling roar, and then a worse sound, a squeaking sound. The T-Rex gate was opening. Dun, dun, dun. Carl was in trouble. There, right before him, was a giant rock. Carl was pretty strong, but the rock wasn't even round. It was shaped like a cube. The game was rigged. Nobody could win. The hissing sound from the snakes all around him didn't even concern him. He had bigger issues. He completely ignored the snakes that were trying to bite his thick, hairy legs. He just didn't care. And then the T-Rex burst out of into the arena. Carl freaked out and ran around the arena in circles, screaming his brains out, much to the delight of the bloodthirsty fans. Carl couldn't believe that these people, even his friends, wanted him to get eaten right in front of them. The T-Rex cornered Carl, and just before it ate him, Carl screamed, ooga. Immediately, Bob the big veggie-eating dinosaur reached inside the stadium and lifted the huge cubicle rock up high into the air. The T-Rex was surprised and looked upward to see what was happening. And then Bob dropped the huge rock on top of the T-Rex, smushing him. The crowd went crazy. They had never seen this much blood before. Carl's friends patted him on the back and told him this was the best show ever. Carl just walked away. He had gotten a new perspective on a very violent activity that people called sport. It wasn't sport, it was cruel, and Carl felt bad that he had once enjoyed it. So Carl went to form the Rock Ball Safety Commission, which instituted things like mouth guards for T-Rexes that prevented the teeth from penetrating the skin. And there were multiple pads placed around the stadium, and the snakes were replaced with those silly rubber snakes you find at the dollar store. Safety was improved, but the ratings went down, and that was the end of rock ball. Judge number one, what do you think? 15, yay! Judge number two.
I have to give you a comment though, because on the connectivity, a little bit low, because anything to do with snakes, I'm not a fan.
That's funny. Judge number two, 17. And judge number three, 8. Oh, he likes. that. Oh.